Hello friends, today I am going to give you some very important information about three powerful exercises called Kan Upkan and Murki. Now these exercises are very effective in singing Taans. Taan is the ascending and descending of notes which are taken in a very fast tempo, and also these exercises are effective in singing the Western style of vibrato. So what is a vibrato? Let's take the notes that are there in Kan. Sa, when you take Sa, you will take the note which is below Sa and just pull it and bring it up. Sa Ni Sa, Re Sa Re, Ga Re Ga, Ma Ga Ma. Okay? Similarly, in Upkan, when you see the word Upa, Upa means Upar Wala, the note which is above. So you take the note which is above Sa, that is Re, and you pull it down with a force. Sa Re Sa, Re Ga Re, Ga Ma Ga, Ma Pa Ma. So, and in Murki, Murki is a combination of Kan and Upkan both, but mainly also Upkan. So Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Mi Sa, Sa Re Ga. This is Murki. So if you look at these exercises, you will notice that three prominent notes are used in these exercises, that is Sa, Ni and Re. And you will wonder that how come only three cluster of notes, such a small cluster of notes, can be so effective, you know, in your day-to-day practice. It is said that the syllable Sa has got or is made from the combination of Sa of Saraswati ji and A of Brahma. So together it became Sa. Similarly, the Ni, which we call Nishad, the Ni consists of Narayan and E of Lakshmi. So together it became Ni. In terms of Re, Re stands for a combination of Rudra and A of Maheshwari. So together it became Re. And it is said that when the mantras, when the sages were uttering the mantras or singing the mantras, they used to use this cluster of Ni, Sa, Re, which actually had the names of these gods, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh and their consorts. And by uttering the names of these gods, the mantras which they were singing had a lot of power. To make them powerful, the Ni, Re and Sa were being used. For example, Sa Ni Sa Re Sa Ni Sa Re Sa Ni Sa Re 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 Ni Sa Re Sa Ni Sa Re Sa. We can take an example of Gayatri Mantra. Om Bhurbhuva Swaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yona Prachodayat. Taking the hidden names of these gods were making the mantras very, very powerful. So similarly, if you take the story where Lord Krishna came to Draupadi and he said that I'm very hungry, please give me something to eat. And Draupadi was very heartbroken because whatever she had cooked for the day was all eaten up by her husbands, the Pandavas. So she brought the empty vessel in which she had cooked the rice, you know, and she showed it to Lord Krishna. And she said, there is nothing today because everything is finished. And she started to weep because she was not able to offer any food to Lord Krishna. And Krishna Bhagwan, he looked into the vessel and then he picked up one small kan, which is a small grain of rice, you know, a small kan of sheath, we call it in Hindi, or chawal. So he pulled that small grain of rice and he said, Draupadi, why are you telling me lies? There is food in this vessel. So she was very surprised and she said, I can't see any food in this vessel. So he said, look at this small grain of rice, this kan of rice. This is going to give me all the energy that I need to feel that I have eaten up today. It's going to give me a lot of happiness, basically. So if you do the exercises Kan, Upkan and Murki, you may think that these are just ordinary exercises. What can they do to me? You know, how can they bring about a difference? But though they may seem very small, you know, even the small Kan and the exercises of Kan are going to make a lot of difference. You don't have to do 100 exercises, you know, to get your Taans and your Vibrato in place. You just do these basic exercises and you will see that they are equal to 100 exercises, effective wise, and to give you the results. I would like to thank my Guruji, Govind Prasad Jaipurwale ji, and Bhavdeep Jaipurwale ji, because when I was a child, they taught me these exercises, and today the Taans or the Vibrato that I'm able to take today, I'm able to do so because of these exercises. So Taan is a fast ascending descending cluster of notes, usually in akar. So this is a Taan. And you will see that in many Bollywood songs, in bhajans, you will find that there are small cluster of these notes. For example, maasam hai aashikana hai dil kahin se unko ko aise mein dhoond lana, aise mein dhoond lana, mausam hai aashikana. Or you can find some small cluster in preet kya judi daur kya bandhi. So these little things, you know, will come in your voice, which otherwise people sing preet kya judi. So it becomes very difficult, you know, you don't know how to sing these songs. These kind of songs with intricate taans become an impossibility. So preet kya judi and preet kya judi, you will take it in this way. Because you will say, I can't sing those difficult cluster of notes. Or even the song.
Lag jaagar ke phir hasee raat ho, na ho, shayad phir se janam ne mulaqat ho, na ho.
See, these notes you will be able to take when you do the exercises Kan, Upkan and Murki. Now some tips. Whenever you do these exercises, you also got to remember that you have always got to keep a 2-finger distance when you open your mouth. Because if you don't open your mouth, then whatever you are singing, it will come and it will touch the teeth and go inside. Like, compared to, so you've seen that your voice has to come out, or if you're doing the Taan, everything becomes crystal clear. So opening your mouth is very important. Secondly, the second most important tip is always sit in front of a mirror and do your vocal exercises. Because sometimes people don't realize that when they open their mouth or they are singing, their mouth can become very, you know, go on one side. You know, and they may not realize that this is happening, and it looks very funny, especially when they are on the stage and they are making all kinds of faces, or if they are doing Taans, you know, if they are not used to doing Kan, Upkan, Murki, then they will have exaggerated movements of the body. So it looks very funny. It looks very funny. So in order to become a good presentator, when you present yourself, you know, it should be very flawless. It should seem like my Guruji Pandit Firoz Dastur used to say that your performance should always be like a duck. You know, you are like gliding, like you're gliding on the water, you know, so beautifully. And when a person looks at a duck or a swan, he sees that it's gliding beautifully. But if you go underwater, you will see that the duck is really flapping. The swan is really flapping its feet, you know. So this riyaz of Kan, Upkan, Murki, this is your flapping of the feet. This is your flapping. And when you go on the stage, because you have flapped so much, because you've done so much of riyaz, you know, your performance becomes effortless. So you have to keep all these points in mind when you do these exercises. It has made a lot of difference in my voice, and I'm very, very sure, in fact I'm 100% sure, that if you do these exercises diligently, then even you will be able to sing all the Taans, all the vibrato flawlessly and effectively. So we'll end up this session today. I hope you all the best. Do go into my channel, look up my exercises which I'm going to give every time, and I hope that these exercises will aid you in your singing. Thank you. Namaste.